All right, everyone. Hello, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are in the world. My name is Jason Levine, and thank you so much for joining me for today's video masterclass. And for this holiday weekend, doing things a little bit differently today, as I alluded to last week, I thought it'd be kind of fun to talk about this concept of logging your 10,000 hours, or after talking with some other fellow colleagues this week about this very masterclass, really more about this concept of 10,000 iterations. I think that makes a lot more sense because it's not so much the amount of time in one sitting necessarily, but the amount of the number of times you attempt something, right? To really get better, right? To get good, to get great, to become excellent, to become proficient, whatever it is, you just need to log those hours. So I started to go back through some audio archives and things, and I pulled a couple of couple of gems from my past, which we'll play towards the end, to show just kind of, again, progression, in this case, in audio engineering, recording, and performance. But for, for our Adobe Live audience today, I thought I'd actually make this an illustration and visual-based 10,000-hour logging session using my own child as the guinea pig to really showcase what logging those hours means. And then having visual references and different Creative Cloud resources that kind of help you stay in check and really see how things have progressed and how you've changed. And we're going to take a look at my little one's work over the last 3 years, which was largely inspired by many of you out there streaming and a couple of my Adobe colleagues. Namely, I want to give a quick shout to Ren Sauer. She's actually someone that I've worked with quite a lot. You've probably seen Ren here on Adobe Live. And she was the one who got me inspired to help my son kind of start really getting into illustration and start drawing and really take him to where he is today. So as always, we're coming to you live on Adobe Live. Want to point out, of course, that if you're going to have any questions, sorry, it was, you want to go to this chat here, b.net/AdobeLive. Yes, I am live today. Want to remind everyone as well that next week, Adobe US is shut down. So we will not have new Adobe Live content next Friday. So just keep that in mind. We'll be back live on the, well, for the Friday masterclasses on July 16th. So if you are taking a July 4th holiday this weekend, have a good one and have a good week next week. We will be out and about and away and offline, and which is fun because I just came from being offline for almost 2 months. So get to go back to it again. Couple quick shout outs before we get started. Jan Eric, no, this is current Jason Jan Eric, not past Jason today. This is live. Reverb Mike, what's up? Steve Kosaboom, Cody Bear, William Polk, Henrik, Cherry Blossom, good to see you. Abdullah Zubair, love your classes. Oh, thank you so much. Watchtower of Babel, cool. Nice to see you. All right, and just making sure we're going to you live everywhere. Looks like we are. Okay, very, very cool. All right, so why don't we go ahead and get started, and let me go ahead and switch over my screen here, and we're going to begin in Photoshop. Now, as some of you, as I've told some of you before, or maybe talked about, you know, I'm definitely not an illustrator. I come from what I like to call the John Lennon school of illustration, and you've seen it here before. In fact, hold on, I still think it's in my, is it in my drawer right here? You've seen my little self-portraits. This is what you're seeing on screen here is, oh yeah, here we go. So I've drawn this on screen. Here, wait, let me go back to the camera here. You see this guy, Beetlejuice. I tend to do this very simple line art style of self-portraiting, very similar kind of in the spirit of John Lennon. And whenever I do a birthday card or any kind of card for my family, I always make this same image of myself now with grayer hair and a beard, but that's me. And then that's my young son, Jacob, whom I affectionately refer to as the monkey lizard. And this is kind of where he started because he would always see me do these little cartoons, always. And normally I have like my hand up waving and the hand always looks weird and the arm never looks right. But this is kind of the level of my of my illustration abilities, all right? So we're gonna start though. I actually created a timeline so that you can appreciate the progress here and really see how, again, logging those hours really makes a significant difference. And it is gonna be quite awesome and quite shocking. So we begin actually 3 years to the month. So we started with my young one here in July 2018 with this first image that you see up here. I'm going to pull this up. And I don't mind telling you that he was six and a half at the time, okay? So here is his first illustration. Cody Bear loves it, nice. Hugh O'Connor, I have a Lennon illustration hanging here. Oh, nice, Janaina, what's up? So my son was 6 and a half at the time. Now, some of you who've watched the masterclass before, just so you don't get weirded out or afraid or, you know, make some unnecessary phone calls, my young one, who happened to have been born on Friday the 13th, oddly enough, he's really into like the horror genre. He's just always loved it. He loves Tim Burton. He loves gory things. He doesn't love death and killing. He just loves the theatrics of it all. And as you can see, front and center in this illustration is a knife and axe wielding Jason Voorhees from Friday the 13th. Also in 2018, he was, I don't know if any of you remember this Deadpool ad where Deadpool was kind of, they were recreating that scene from Flashdance from 1983 or whatever it was, where the woman is on the chair, the dancer, and like the water's coming down. So that's him kind of remaking that. I don't know how he even saw that poster. He saw it somewhere at the time. So he was kind of redrawing that. But as you take a look here, this looks like a six-year-old's drawing, probably, or whatever. I don't know. I don't know kid ages anymore. But this is where we started, okay? So this is where it began. And shortly thereafter, my friend Ren suggested, you know, having him watch a couple of recommended videos. Hold on, I don't want to cancel changes. No. Click OK. Including some videos from our very own Cody Bear, who is in the chat today. Lovely to see you, Cody. And among a couple of other friends that I know out there, Kyle Webster among them, and then a couple of other different YouTubers who do just really very basic styles of drawing, just to kind of get you started. And again, as a six-year-old, he was really into Friday the 13th and Jason and Michael Myers and all this kind of crazy stuff. He was also very much into Sonic. So this is where we kind of go about 3 months later. So there's a 3 month period of progression. And the first thing you're gonna notice in October, I'm gonna pull up these two images here, are cleaner lines, and he stopped filling things in. So I think part of one of the things that he probably started seeing or hearing about in a lot of these illustration videos is just really finding your lines, right? Let's not worry about filling stuff in. Let's just get the lines just right. So already in a couple of months, you can see, if we just pull up that other one, I mean, you can kind of see it here. I don't need to pull it up full screen again. We're already making some progress. Now, obviously, you know, where there's overlaps and things like here, I mean, he's still six, right? But there's already some progression. And I remember he was very into Sonic at the time. And when he drew this, I just thought, wow, amazing kid. I'm going to put this up on the wall. And I did for a brief period of time. So already a progression in about 3 months. And it's worth pointing out that at this stage, he was probably doing anywhere from 10 to 30 illustrations a day. It's also worth pointing out that after 3 years, he's gone through easily 15 of those moleskin notebooks that we used to give out at Adobe Max and whatnot. Many of you have them. 15. Every page, cover to cover, and I don't know, countless binders of illustration paper. I mean, just thousands of pages, right? So we see a little bit of a progression there. Again, same time frame. This is October. He just likes this. I know. Born on Friday the 13th. I mean, what can I tell you? He just likes it. All right. And again, already here, when you look at this and you look at this mask, okay, if we go back and kind of compare it, I keep doing that. I have to click OK on this. If we go back to, let me see if I can find the original here. Again, that first one. You know, look, the eyes are like, there's no symmetry. There's no real continuity there. But when we look at this, you know, already we're starting to get a bit more of a body form. It's still not quite all right, right? Head's kind of too big, shoulders too small. Got a nice little thin waist there. Hand overlaps are, you know, interesting, but there's an attempt here to refine the process. So this is kind of 3 months, you know, 10 to 20, 30 pages a day. By the way, every page, you know, if there's two lines on it and he didn't like it, he would go to a new page. So not every page is completely filled corner to corner. But it's just this idea that he kept going. Somewhere along the line, though, he hit upon, you know, after progressing through, I think, a couple of Kyle's videos, where we were talking about, you know, form and shapes. So what was really interesting as someone outside of this to watch is to see the approach to illustration. And it's actually made me think a lot about how I do it, too. You know, I didn't study this, so I never really studied body form and shape and how to start, you know, by using an oval for a head and then sort of, you know, drawing the line to show the center and all these things. I didn't do that. And thus, when I make my little illustrations, I don't do that. Well, after about, let's see, 5 months, he started watching videos where that was the theme, form and shapes. So if we come over to this one here, now we're in roughly December. He's a very sweet child, I promise you. It's not, you know, there's no... I can't explain these things, okay? He's still 6 here, by the way. Form, shape, right? And you can see how he was starting to identify. There's also a bit of like dimensionality here, right? You can kind of feel a greater sense of depth, of Z depth, of position. He's even got a little bit of a shading right here. That was probably accidental. But again, compared to 4 or 5 months ago, suddenly the lines are cleaner. There's a better sense of, you know, deliberate lines and a really deliberate use of shapes to begin the process, okay? People watching this externally tuning in now going, what is happening here? Now, I happen to know, because I just happen to remember that this was around January. So he worked on this stuff for a solid month, just doing outlined versions of the human form. Coming back to Deadpool. Oh, sorry, here's another Jason. So again, kind of revisited from those earlier two iterations. You can see now we're starting to get, again, just a bit more definition. He was also into this character, Bendy. Any of you know Bendy and the Ink Machine there? But by January, form really started to take on a whole new meaning for him. And this was an illustration that he was doing of Deadpool. Again, I think this is one of the marketing poses. And there was some YouTuber who was like, how to draw Deadpool from the Deadpool 2 poster or something like that. Okay. So what you're seeing here, again, is just like an awareness. I mean, look at just the shoulder caps and the difference in, you know, bicep and tricep and forearm, the kneecap here. I mean, these are all things that I'm watching this unfold and going, wow, he's learning. He's really understanding. If you want to, this is what you need to do, right? To improve your characters, to improve those lines, to improve the realism. There's so many things, and to accelerate significantly, right? So this is, you know, roughly 6 months after that, right? Kind of hard to believe, but logging those hours, right? And it's not all day, every day. Despite, I mean, this was pre-quarantine, so everybody was in school, everybody was doing their thing, activities. I think he was playing soccer or football or whatever at that point in time. All right. But we're seeing that progression. Let me just check up on our chat here. Janaina, wow, haha. Future comic book artist right there. You called it, Jan Erik. We're going to get back to that at the very end here. Cody Berry picks up on instruction very well. He really does, and he's very into it. And that's the thing, right? And it's also worth pointing out that in this process, like I said, he might have started one of those, kind of messed up, and rather than necessarily erase everything, he probably started on a new page. So there were moments of frustration, but I didn't witness just the total, throw the book kind of thing, which is probably what I would have done. He just kept doing it, right? So as he started to refine shapes and the understanding of shapes and lines, now we started getting into shading and detail. So now we're at approximately the 1 year mark, right? Which is really interesting. And you'd say, well, how many hours, how many iterations was that? I mean, like I said, in that first year, in a 200 page, 8.5 by 11 binder of white thick stock paper, he'd probably already been through easily 5 of those books and a couple of moleskins, right? So clearly already a few thousand iterations, even if only partially completed, of this style. So let's now dip into 1 year later, July, and take a look at what was happening here. Oh, sorry, I went too far. Nonsense. Arg, not that one. Oh, sorry. I skipped ahead. I missed March. Oh, darn it. Sorry. Flargle gargle. Okay. So we were just in December, January, right? Lines. March. I forgot about this. So I told him at this point in time, and this was actually, he was inspired by Kyle had done an illustration for Spider-Man. Was this Into the Spider-Verse? Early 2019? I mean, it may have already come out, but he did something around Spider-Man. It could have been, he could have done it a year earlier. My son found it. So he wanted to try Adobe Draw and Fresco. And, you know, he already had an iPad, we had an Apple Pencil, but totally new to this medium. So this is kind of where we started. The first thing that he attempted, he's really into this character whose name I just forgot. Somebody say it in the chat. I can't remember. It'll come back to me. Venom. First attempt in Adobe Draw. This is pre-Fresco. And you can see he sort of used the tools that he had from the more traditional art style, but not really comfortable with using the pencil, not really comfortable with the stylus, not really comfortable with just working digitally. So we revisited this concept a few times. So we started there. This is, again, another character from Bendy and the Ink Machine, Boris. And you can see that he's already applying a lot of those other techniques. So, like, if you look at the hands, and I think about we had an artist on here years ago on Adobe Live. He's one of my favorites, Mike Milo. He's done a ton of stuff. Pinky and the Brain, Uncle Grandpa, countless amounts of cartoons and things that we watch. He's an amazing illustrator. And he always talked about the hands. And when I saw this, I remember telling my son, like, wow, you know, the hands look really good. Note also that he's doing the four-fingered hand, so he's sort of aware of that, you know. There's some shading in here. Again, sort of coloring out of the lines, how to find the lines. I think he was just finding that mind-body connection with the Apple Pencil, which, you know, can be a little challenging. He's still, at this point, he's almost seven, all right? And he went a little abstract with this one. It says searcher. I don't even know who or what this is. This is some creepy thing. But again, when you saw sort of lines and things, I mean, he's obviously outlined this. You can see there's some definition and just detail in the splatter at the bottom. It feels like liquid. I mean, he was moving forward. But he felt very uncomfortable with the Apple Pencil. And he actually asked me, and I'm going to go back to... And he said, Dad, would you be upset if I went back to using pencils and paper? And I said, no, why would I be upset? And he said, well, you work for Adobe. You don't make the pencils and paper. So, sorry, but I'm streaming. So I said, of course not. No, we can go back to paper. That's fine. So he wanted to go back to paper. And that was the move he needed to make, because this allowed him now to kind of continue where he left off. He didn't feel quite comfortable enough yet going digitally. And that's fine. And, you know, I think it's funny. I've talked to Kyle about this. I've talked to some other streamers about this. I think some people just, well, you just have to use whatever works for you, right? And he's learning. So I think the curve of not only trying to learn the concepts, but also acclimate to the medium, he just didn't love it. So let's go back to where we left off. All right. So that was March. So now we're in July. So he does draw and beta of Fresco for about 2 to 3 months. Experiment. We did hundreds and hundreds of iterations of various things. So many. In fact, I had to delete a whole bunch in my CC libraries because it's my account. Hundreds of drawings of Sonic and of all these characters. And there's a bunch of Jasons and Michael Myers in there. I didn't put them all in here. There were many. But now we're in July. Now we're back on pencil and paper. And again, all this time, he's been really focusing on detail, right? Detail and starting to understand the concept of shading, right? At this point, everything's pretty much either just painted in, you know, it's either flat, 100% opacity, or just nothing. Now he's trying to start to introduce the concept of shading, right? And of really adding sort of shading and detail. So let's go to this first one here. Hopefully these are all in order. All right. So this is, yet again, this is an alternate Sonic for those of you that my gaming friends out there. This is Sonic EXE. All right. And the first thing I noticed, right, the lines. really clean. All right. Obviously did a bit of erasing here, but there's great symmetry in all of this, right? In the ears, in the thickness of the lines, and how he's changed. Always a little bit of blood. All right. There's some real symmetry with the left and right sides of his head here. And I thought, holy cow. Like, just that alone, again, from the outside looking in, this is a huge amount of progress. All right. Let's take a look at Sonic here. All right. Now, if we go back to that original Sonic, can I pull this? Oh, it's not going to let me pull it up with camera open. Really? There we go. Okay. Here we go. What do we see that's different? Well, again, first of all, the eyes, right? There's this concept of the pupil and the other parts of the eye, right? And the highlights in the eyes. Right? This is, you know, I'm no art critic, but I mean, I could see, like, wow, you've progressed your understanding. There's still some overlap here. Oh, also note, some shading in the fur on the ends, right? And it's the same expression, but there's more life behind it now. This is still good. I still love it. But when I look at, you know, these a year apart, I'm going, okay, there's been a real progression here. Now, at this point, we are, again, we're thousands of iterations in, but you're really starting to see how this has evolved, okay? And keep going here. Perspective on the eyes. Yes, that's the word, Umacorn. Gosh, I couldn't even. Oh, and yes, I see. Bruce Gonzalez is saying, do I see a signature at the top left? Thank you. See, I'm talking through this. One of the things I said to him, now you're going to keep note, you're going to note, he started to do this. I said, you need to sign your work, bud. You know, for what reason? Because it's yours. Sign your work. Right? So he started to do that. Now you're going to see his signature. It's going to evolve over time. Right now. So that very good. Good eye there. I love that. Love this community. So here's his kind of a half cursive J into an L. He was very also into Pennywise. We have a 7-foot Pennywise animatronic creature that we bought at the spirit store that we use for Halloween. So we have a live version of this in the house. This is not the greatest Pennywise, but what I loved about this is, again, there's shading. There's some, the perspective is a little different here, but there's concept of it, you know, and again, just sort of definition and detail and difference in, I mean, there's not a perfect crosshatch here, but as I look at the lines, they're not all this, you know, it's not a scribble fill-in, right? There's like deliberate shading going on here, right? Definite progression from time. And then once again, we revisit our old friend Sonic. This was on, so this is like, you know, June. So just somewhere, just before July, just about a year. But the reimagined Sonic here, right? He's gave me this for Father's Day. So again, just a little, you know, little comparison, you know, where we started, where we ended up, right? Now this one, you can see this was just, it was either crayon or color pencil. I joked with him because I said, looks like you did it a little quickly, bud, but you know, take a look, again, look at the difference in a year, right? The socks or whatever these are versus this, right? Good concept of, oh no, those overlap. Either have to erase or draw them in advance. You know, same with the hands, with his cuffs, right? Also, there's an imbalance of fingers here, 5 on this one, 4 on this one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Here, 4 fingers on each, all right? Those little subtle details. And again, it's that same sideways expression, albeit with the head turned the other direction, but there's just more life in it now, you know? And I was very excited to see that progression. Okay, also misspelled gorilla down there. We'll give him that one, okay. All right. So that's 1 year in. Let's check it here. Tim, what's up? Accomplishment, ownership, yes. All right. So, you know, that again is kind of a look at 1 year. So now we're going to cut to October. And between July and October, and as I was looking through all the different stuff that he did when I was selecting some of these, this is where he was really now focusing on musculature and definition. So again, this could have been in one of Kyle's courses. There's a few other YouTubers that he watches, but where they were really covering like how to draw an arm, because he's also into, you know, superheroes and stuff. So he's drawn Thor, he's drawn Iron Man, he's drawn the Hulk. How do you really create that sense of definition? So when we take a look at this image here, all right, which he also got very into, he was very into ninjas at this point, as many seven-year-olds are, myself included. You know, this is sort of a first attempt, but you can see now, first of all, as we start to investigate here, eyes, shading, differences in shading, detail, perspective, shoulder, cap, chest, abs, you know, a cinched waist with delts. I mean, it's... I'm looking at this going, you're drawing differently than you did yesterday, right? And this was his major focus. So what's interesting is, and I realized this as I was making this timeline, at this point, he, in music, did what we call hit the shed and just went back and did nothing but work on bodies and detail and musculature and shading. So basically all the things up until this point, so about a year and 3-4 months in, he now just spent the next, well, year really, year and a half, just working on that. And as with many artists, he didn't want me photographing a lot of those images. By the way, these are just me taking pictures of his stuff over time. And then of course, you know, shortly after this, we hit COVID. So during the beginning of COVID, you can even see up and through July, everybody was home, everybody was shedding, everybody was working on stuff, and he was working on all that. So really between October 2019, not really until December 2020, a mere 7-8 months ago, did I photograph anything. So here's where it gets really interesting and fun, right? So now we're gonna start to see this massive leap, because between this period of time, right? So however many months that is, well, I guess a year and 2 months, several thousand more iterations, probably four. I think we went through 8 of those 200 page books. And again, another 4 or 5 moleskins. I had tons of these moleskins from years. We used to give those away. So I just kept giving them to him. They were old, still sealed. Some of them still said Creative Suite. So I was giving them to him and he was just plowing through these books, finishing them. All pen, and of course at this point too, we're investing a lot in pencils, and he wanted to try ink and do all these different formats, and we tried watercolor and color pencil and all these things. So when we hit December 2020, now is where we're gonna start to see, oh wait, no, stop! Yelling at myself. They're out of order. Oh, can I stop doing this? Thank you. Oh. So here we are, a year and 2 months later. This one looks like it was done in pen. So when we again cut to that first image and then start looking at this, first of all, deliberate lines, deliberate marks, all small details. This is a very, very, this whole drawing was about this big. So this is a blown up image. There's detail, there's symmetry, little nod to some sort of Japanese calligraphy here. We'll get to that in a second. Stole my own thunder already. But what happened during quarantine in terms of his artistic sense and desire and passion for illustration? I did it again. Just click OK. What's wrong with me? What happened was he discovered anime, specifically Naruto. He discovered Naruto. So this was right as he was discovering Naruto. And by the way, this was a sort of self-portrait combining himself. This is the first time, by the way, that he did this. So that's supposed to be him in a mask, again, kind of modeling the eyes and style, again, off Naruto. The mask was twofold, because I was like, is it masked because everybody's masked up? Yes, but also to the style. Got a bit of the Deadpool double swords in the back, and I think there was a football there because he likes football. I don't know. I'm not sure what that is. Discovering anime. And here we are. So this is, what did I say? This is December 2020. And when he showed me this, one, it's just a completely different style, right? And suddenly, we're looking at expressions and expression lines with very deliberate marks here, right? A really good sense of perspective and size and scale and space. This was kind of his first iteration. This was a few days later. So this was right when he started. And this is like refining it a few days later. Okay. This completely freaked me out because I thought, wow, you've just crossed the threshold here. All right. But it didn't stop there, of course, because now combined with him, one, trying to develop his own character style sense, drawing himself kind of in that style, but also now really focusing on facial expression and lines and character lines, he starts to kind of branch out into different types of characters. So hold on, I think it's 22. Okay, that's him. Okay. So now we're going to March. So now we're in March of 2021. So this is 3 months ago. All right. And if any of you are into that game Undertale, so this is Sans from Undertale. So this was, he started drawing hundreds of these things and Sans doing all kinds of things. This was a quick one-off for me because he had, again, if anyone's an Undertale fan here, this kid is going places. Oh, thanks, Howard. it's very common for artists to go through an anime phase. I had mine in middle school, right? Well, both my kids are really into it. Again, my older one kind of inspired the younger one. But this right here, I thought, okay, this is, again, he's doing characters differently. By the way, note the signature has also morphed. It's way more stylized. I love the jet. I mean, it's the line. It's like real calligraphy style. It's really good. But this is Sans, all right? So again, you see the shading, the perspective, the detail, the expression. You know, there's something very organic and studied when looking at this. And I don't know anything, and I can see it, right? But now we really start to just go crazy, go experimental and really start to see him opening up. Now, mind you, he's just turned 9 now. So now we were at 6.5, now we're at 9. All right. And let's take a look. These were both done within a few days of his 9th birthday. So I mentioned Naruto. So this was the first full attempt at Naruto. We saw one of the earlier ones. Now, he didn't love this. He didn't want me to keep this image. He said, well, the face is too wide and it's not right and the shoulders are wrong and he doesn't have, the neck is wrong. Like he drew the jacket incorrectly. The neck is narrow, but the jacket's too wide. He wasn't very happy with this. I just looked at it and thought, you're making some real progress here. Don't get disappointed, but he really didn't like it. So that was attempt number one. I'm gonna have to pull these side by side because here's attempt number two, which also introduces him doing another character, one of his favorites, which is Marshmallow. All right. Same time frame, days later, and probably 100 iterations later. All right. Let's go back to this for a second. Where were we? Number 23. Yeah. All right. So where we started with this, where we end up. Now, to be honest, this may be a different character. This may be someone else in Naruto. I'm currently on AOT, by the way. Who's into Attack on Titan? Anybody here into AOT? So I haven't watched Naruto, so I don't know if this is meant to be the same character or a different character. But in any case, when you look at the progression here, and I start looking at the eyes and the detail and the definition and all of the eraser marks. You know, this is how I know that he's watching, and as Cody pointed out, he's really, he's understanding and taking in that information, because all of this is deliberate, right? I look at the details. I mean, these eyes are fantastic. There's real expression in here. There's something very creepy and wonderful about what he's trying to do, and you can see it. Again, the marshmallow one, this was a quick one-up. You can see, too, he started to draw something in the middle here. It didn't work. He just sort of left it there. The pages aren't always clean, you know? He's not afraid to leave them and get them dirty, all right? Let's go back into Photoshop here. All right, so that's April. It's a mere 2.5 months ago. More iterations, hundreds more iterations. Let's keep going now. Still into anime, still doing this daily. Now, we're still in school through mid-May, and here we were fortunate that my boys were both physically in school as opposed to remote. But post-school, drawing. Homework, drawing, dinner, bed. That's it, right? Some say GTL, his is homework, dinner, HDD, homework, drawing, dinner, bed, HDDB, all right? Starting to date the illustrations, May 15th. Consistent with the signature now. I'm not sure if this is, I thought this was an AOT character. Kind of looks like one of the Titans, although it's not because they're not dressed. I'm not sure which character this is, but again, he pulled this out and said, "What do you think?" And just the detail. I'm going, this is a new style for you. You've completely changed, right? And it's a grown-up style, right? 10,000 iterations. Now, 2 months prior is when he started, or how many months? No, 4 months, 5 months prior is when he started doing the self-portrait thing. So he started trying to integrate himself into some of these and make a character of himself that could be part of this sort of anime manga world that he was trying to recreate. So this was his first attempt at that. You can see this is 6 days later. 521, all right? Now, while I, you know, there's some things that are very, very creepily accurate, particularly the hair, right? And just kind of the expression. That isn't a sadness tear. Apparently that's something in Naruto, means something. But trying to introduce a little more color here. Right, at this point, by the way, we're still all monochrome. We're still black and white. Hasn't really introduced a lot of color recently. We're doing a lot of black and white. And he started to get into the concept of inking around this time as well. So this was just a little over a month ago, May. But June is where it all comes together. So really now we're at almost the 3-year mark, okay? So this is where we started. Now again, this is some character, I don't know who, from, could be Naruto, could be Boruto, could be another show. The signature. This is currently the cover of my phone's home screen or lock screen. And I just love this. I love the lines here, the definition, the shading, the shadowing, the perspective. I just noticed the hair going into his eye, right? Overlapping. But there's real emotion and expression in this, right? I felt so connected to this image, I didn't even know what to say to him. I almost cried because I'm now feeling his expression through his marks. And I remember when we introduced, anybody remembers Ink and Slide? So Adobe very briefly made a pen and a ruler for our then mobile drawing apps. And the engineer who worked on this used to talk about how you deliver that emotional feeling and connection, or just the emotion translated from your mind to the pen, to the page, to the viewer. And that's what I saw when I saw this. I thought, I'm feeling something when I see this. You know? When you look at a young kid's illustration of whatever, a bear, a whatever, a man, a donkey, whatever, you're like, oh, it's so cute, it's so nice, it's cool, well done. You don't necessarily feel something. I could feel something. I'm looking at this going, what is this dude thinking? What is this person thinking? This is a smirk. It's almost like, Mona Lisa-esque there, that expression. Because it's not happy, it's not sad, it's sort of in the middle, all right? This one, 613. He went old school here, no cursive, he stamped it. This one was a little different than most of the others because it introduced two characters. You can see there's this woman hiding behind him there. This one took a lot out of him, took him a long time to finish. And then we had an incident, as kids often do. I'll show you this here. And he got very upset. And here's something you can't do with the digital versions. You can't tear them. Aw, man. He tore it. He got very upset and ripped it. I saved it. And it was photographed, fortunately, before it was torn. Everybody gets a little frustrated. You hear me get frustrated. When I was 10, Cody says, my brother saw my art and told me to keep drawing every day and to never throw anything away, even if I don't like it, so I can look back on my progress. Right? Giannis, I love AOT. You should try Naruto. Excellent. Very cool. HDDB, Umicorn's into that. Beautiful moment, Bruce Gonzalez. So, again, you're seeing that, like, progression here. I believe the next one is, yet again, another self. Yeah. So, this is another iteration on the self-portrait that we saw a minute ago. Here, I'm just going to put these side by side. Again, same kind of style. Same sort of, same vibe in terms of, like, there's similarities here. The difference is now, oh, you're not seeing my screen. Arg, how long have you not been seeing my screen? Oh my gosh. Yeah, I don't know what happened there. Sorry, y'all. Here's the new iteration from June. Here's the May version. Really nailed the hair here, the eyes. You can see it says, my name is Hiroyuki, H-E-R-O, Hiro, not H-I-R-O. Trying to put himself into these worlds. But you can already see just the change and the slight differences to really alter his sort of character style, all right? He's masked here again. And again, I asked him, was that a COVID mask or is this a, what is this representing here? You know, different things. All right. And then this one. So this is right at the end of June. Slightly modified signature again. But this for me is kind of his piece de resistance. This is just literally a few days ago. And I put in here a little progress. So this was him in progress doing about it. You can see the hair. This was him just putting those finishing touches on it. And these are the books that I'm talking about, those 200 page tear out kind. Some perforated, some not. Classic pencil here. Now, by the way, he does have a whole set of these very nice, fancy drawing pencils. I noticed this when I pulled this picture up yesterday. It was like classic, you know, number two Ticonderoga here. So people ask, you know, what is it? Does it matter what I'm using to draw or to if I play guitar with a Sears guitar versus a Gibson? Or... No, none of that matters. Just do it a lot, right? Now, I pulled this one. There's two others here I wanted to share because, so this was a friend. And again, just talking about him kind of creating this, his own personal hanging out the other day. And his friend said, hey, can you draw me? And he just sat in front of him and did this. And it's a quick drawing, right? I don't know if he's going to yet get a job at Disney yet, but It's very stylistic, right? And it's his style now. He's actually kind of created this thing and he nailed the hair. The hair on this, the direction of the it's looks like this kid's hair. Like he really got that down and I was very impressed because it's those little details that I really pay attention to in art and music and everything else. And then the last image that I had here to share with you was just This is just something that I saw. He had the page open. This was the other day, and it just said more to work on. I don't even know what this is. This is some kind of weird work in progress. I don't know what show or character this is from or if this is an original. But again, based on all the things we've been talking about, you can see that there's, you know, definition, shadow, perspective, all of these elements now coming together. And he's free to kind of just work on them and reiterate on them and then move on to something else, right? So in closing, before we go to my quick little musical experience here, where we started, where we ended up, and that's 3 years apart right there. 3 years ago to the month, and now. 10,000 iterations. Can happen to any of you, to anybody. And it could be something new, right? That's the thing too. I imagine if I started drawing today, maybe in 3 years. I mean, I'm not starting here necessarily. I'm not too far from it. I'm not afraid to say that. I'm not starting here, but I'm definitely not here. And I'm definitely not even in the middle. I'm, you know, you saw single lines, very, very, very simple single lines. So it's just really exciting to see that kind of progression. Okay, for our last 6-7 minutes or so, what I thought we would do, Cody, the newest drawing has great muscle definition. Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. What, portraits already? Nice. Henrik, pen and paper, besides Wacom the best. Yes. Great shot, very nice. Oh, cool. Thank you. Okay. So for our last couple minutes, what I want to do is, I thought in the spirit of all this, I couldn't find, I didn't have time to find, I should say, my earliest recorded archives, which go back, I mean, I have studio recordings of myself that are 35 years old. Sheesh. I don't have those with me today. The oldest I could find was from 31 years ago. Now, part of how I got started in my musical journey, separate from the video journey, that would be another course, is by remaking Beatles songs. I had a 4-track recorder, it's back in the day, and I just used to go every day after homework, dinner, then in my little home studio until bedtime. So homework, dinner, studio, bed, HDSB. I would go in every day and remake a Beatles song and try and do a song a day. Sometimes it took me 2 days or 3 days. Sometimes I'd have to finish it over the weekend. I would play all the parts, so drums, bass, guitar, keyboards, some of these 80s ones I had back then. But I wanted you to hear just, again, a bit of the progression. So bear with me here. I'm gonna turn off the noise reduction briefly. Okay. Hopefully this doesn't make me lose sync. So we're going to go back to the earliest one I could find. Two, actually, from February of 1990. So I've got... I can't play these entirely, although I don't know that these will get flagged as their covers. So again, remade a lot of Beatles songs and tried to do them exact. So stereo panning and positioning part for part so they sounded exactly like the originals. So let's first start with a little bit of Lady Madonna, recorded in February of 1990, all right? Oh, and here, I'm gonna make this a little bit louder for you here. Okay.
Lady Madonna, children at your feet, wonder how you managed to make ends meet.
Okay, you get the idea. That's my 15 and a half year old singing voice. Okay, so not bad, obviously. Kind of made my way already. I'd already been recording about 3 years with this 4-track, so I had a pretty good base of what to do and whatnot. Still sounds kind of like a, you know, a then teenage kind of recording, but definitely on its way. Let's take a quick listen to this one here. So this is Rain. I'll do the same thing here and make it a little bit louder. So, again, same time period, same year. Now, I've got some other things in between. Let's cut ahead now to 4 years later, all right? So 4 years and many, many hundreds, easily probably 1,000 or so iterations, recordings later. And this is me remaking Maxwell's Silver Hammer, okay? Now, this has now been upgraded to an 8-track, 1-inch machine. But same thing, trying to recreate the exact same sound, and let's take a listen.
Joan was quizzical, studied about the physical science in the home. Late nights all alone with a test tube. Maxwell Edison, majoring in medicine, calls her on the phone. I take you out to the pictures, Joan. But as she's getting ready to go, a knock comes on the door. Bang, bang, Maxwell's silver hammer came down upon her head. Bang, bang, Maxwell's silver hammer made sure that she was dead.
Right? I mean, that one's pretty damn spectacular, if I do say so myself. Again, my singing wasn't yet studied. I wasn't really a singer then. I was really behind the glass and would play and sing background vocals. I never really sang lead, so a little rough. But musically, you can see the evolution. You can hear the evolution. And I wanted to play one more example here, or maybe two. So that's 94. Post-college, now I've got a studio living in Nashville, recording a lot of different bands. This is one that I did. They were called Backwaters. This song called Dirty Laughing. And again, now this is in my studio. This is a 16-track digital. And take a quick listen to this. Oh, and by the way, Bruce was asking, did I ever try drawing with him? I did. I was really more interested in kind of watching. But yes, in the very beginning, actually, he had me draw stuff with him. But I didn't want to overshadow, and I didn't want to make it feel like we were, I just wanted him to kind of get experimental. So I sat back and really just watched in awe. But yes, I did do it, and I think that kind of inspired him to kind of keep going. So here's Dirty Laughing by Backwaters. Louder for you, sorry.
Forgotten how to speak. You feel like Novocaine. Now my cousin empty me. I've been chewed, I've been spit out. Well, I've been dead. Now I'm learning through your game. You think you manipulator. You think you're Darth Vader.
Okay. So again, as you listen to the engineering, the clarity, the detail, the presence, does it sound like a finished, you know, pro record? Now, yes, you know. If we go back to, here's my old studio as a teenager, 1991.
Beautiful baby, take my hand and you'll see I'll never let you go.
Here's 10 years after that. So this is 2001. This was in the process of recording a still unreleased record real quickly. And take a quick listen to this. And that's going to take us out, friends. So until next time, have a great rest of your morning, afternoon, evening, wherever you are in the world. And we will see you then. Julia's up next with the DCC. Take care, and we'll see you then. Have a great holiday. Bye-bye, everybody.